God blesses us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center with so many different people with so many different needs. Tell us your name.
My name is L.A. White.
And who is this?
Miss Althea Garrett.
And how are y'all related?
We're friends.
Are you? And you take care of her?
Yes, I've had her since 2011 and 2013.
And what are some of the needs she's facing?
We're going to have to do mental health. Mm-hmm. And we're going to have to do housing for a nursing home.
Are you?
Yes.
Has she been helping you a lot?
Yes. Very much.
And now you are facing some needs yourself. Tell us about them.
I'm going to be going to the JFK Cancer Center in Dallas, Texas for, it's called Parkland Plus Program, and they're going to be putting me in the cancer center.
What kind of cancers do you have?
I have thyroid cancer, GI liver cancer, and possible lung cancer.
Now, you came to New Life Evangelistic Center because you had nowhere else to go?
No. We came here for Christmas and something went wrong and we got abandoned here.
And then you came here because you didn't have anywhere else to go.
Yes.
How important is it that this place stays open to all the homeless people, the women, the children, the veterans day after day? How important is it we keep it open?
When you call 211, their program and their policy is that you have to be evaluated before you can go in. And they go through a lot of process and they don't take people that have mental health and they don't take people that have illnesses because they say you're a high risk.
So that was the mayor's hotline for the homeless. Now it's a homeless resource hotline. You call that and they don't take you in. And if this place was not open, y'all might have had to sleep where?
We'd be in a box.
What do you mean you'd be in a box?
I'd be in BOX in a box.
You would have died.
Probably so, yes.
That's what we mean by they contribute to violence. There's so much violence already. Contribute to deaths. These politicians that want to put a padlock on the door at 1411 Locust. These politicians that want us to cease and desist. Those that want us to shut down by April 1st. It's a matter of life and death for a lot of people, isn't it?
Yes, a lot of people.
What would happen to her?
I don't know what would happen. She'd probably be in a box, too.
Would you?
Yes, sir.
You need help, do you?
Yes.
This is why we are working so hard here at the New Life Evangelistic Center and why we need your prayer so much and why I want to encourage you to please share that much-needed tax-deductible gift with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Go online at New Life Evangelistic Center. See the wide variety of programs. So much more than just shelters provided here. We have a day shelter for women, for children, on-the-job training programs, opportunities for others to help at this moment. And that's why it's so grieving when we see these candidates running for mayor saying they just want to put a padlock on this place, like Lila Cruson and Treasurer Jones and others. It's just tragic to see it. They don't know what's going on here. They don't know there's a safe, secure environment here, and they don't know that so much is taking place to help people.
True. I agree with you.
You know that on a day-by-day basis yourself?
Yes, I do.
Well, we can't leave this lady with three types of cancer out on the streets to die, nor the friend she's taking care of that has Alzheimer's disease. Is that
Alzheimer's,
right?
Yes, she has Alzheimer's.
They need help. And that's why we keep our doors open here at this place. And that's why I need you to continue to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Utilize your social media to help share these individual stories. Continue to just hold this place up in your daily prayers, because we never know who's going to come through these doors on a day-by-day basis. But we want to be there when people are hurting. Just in the short time you've been here, you've seen a lot of different people, haven't you?
Yes, every day. It's different
And in
people.
Fact, there was a period of time where you had to go to the hospital. But when you got out, you knew you had a place to come back to, people who cared about you.
I've been in a hospital 3 times.
Wow. And each time they were able to continue to provide a place for your friend here. And
they put us both in the same room, and she had a bed and I had a bed.
They did at the same time?
We were in the same room. I had a private room.
Wow. But then you would have had to go back to the streets if this place hadn't been open, probably.
Yes.
But now they have a home. Don't let them put her out of the home. Please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Let your voice be heard. Continue to share the story. Continue to pray. And please continue to give to New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. How I thank God for those of you that are praying and caring and sharing at this critical time.